Thank you very much, Architector Cucchi. Let me represent you now, Architect Giuseppe Longhi, who is honoris causa in architecture from UASE Sofia. His topic of teaching activities in the last years was sustainability in the counts of urban planning and at Laura Magistrales in architecture for sustainability and in the scientific management of the master in sustainable urban project. The aims of the aims of these activities are developing projects, saving resources, thinking to the future, working in a shared way, organized in according with local agenda 21 principles, with principles according to topics and objective of main international conventions. These activities are carried on according to lifelong learning principles, supported by the interactive platform of the University of Vienna in synergy with international net management managed by the Technical University of Barcelona, UNESCO chair in 16 sustainability. Alternatives, the Kergi Paris and Urban Challenge International Net. Thank you.
Thank you to the International Academy of Architecture and my friend of WACEG, especially Katia Sentova and Zamfir Jadir for the invitation. My speech concerns sustainable disruption. The sustainable design processes today are driven by disruptive waves of innovation that reiterate the famous question of Cedric Price: technology is the answer. But what was the question? I try to illustrate the complex context of relation between the many innovations underway and the sustainable design of the space, giving evidence to the overlap of logical organizational model generated by these waves of transformation. The operation is not simple because innovation dynamics generates externalities of all types and ecologies of value and increasing interconnection between different systems. In the history of design, there are excellent experiences of sustainable design, but today, as usual, projects are impository, demiurgic, often wrong, because politics, companies, and artists think to achieve a complex goal in a linear way, a model far from possessing the complex alphabet that should govern current sustainable planning. I will try to explain this complex world with a narrative assuming as a driving forces the Vitruvian Man in his radical mutation and exploit the chaotic and casual dance of disruptive events marking the manipulation of space evolution. These events are: one, the evolution of relation between man, machine and nature; two, the evolution of connectivity from computer to global connectivity, social and physical; three, the nanobiotech up to the bionic city. I think the sustainable urban design poses two great issues. How sustainable design could manage an evolutive system of disruptive events dominated by the passage from mechanical to biological world, different environments, biotical, physical, space, be it, need multiple design alphabets, environmental, economical, social, technological, and this generates asymmetries hard to manage. From our capacity to create new approach to knowledge and to develop synergies between new design and social alphabets will depend on the success of urban communities in harmony with man and nature. First narrative, Superman versus the limit of the resources. The first question is the evolution of the image of man over time, from Vitruvius Man to the robot. In time, the relation man-space-resources changed radically, passing from the iconical Renaissance Vitruvius Man image enrolled in a physical environment, its liberation from the walls of Denk, Le Corbusier, Modulor, and rationalist movement, its immersion in the waste of the Second Industrial Revolution with the birth of sustainability movement, the discovery of his neuronal dimension with the neuronal man of Shenzhou, its immersion in the beats like Tarzan in the media forest, its substitution with the robot, ending rapid in its synapses in a biotic dimension of the design. The Sustainable Project is called to face this tsunami of innovation, starting with the harmony between man and artifact, and ending in a contradictory way, with the change of the man with robot and with the genetic manipulation of the human body. The evolution of the man is connected with three technological revolutions: sustainability, connectivity, bioproductivity. In half a century, we have moved from the way of production by subtraction of matter, typical of the Industrial Revolution, to the generative production of the biological revolution, passing through the revolution of connectivity between people, between things, and between people and things. The Industrial Revolution had the mitigation of sustainability. The other revolution is still waiting for a management socially shared. This evolution of the man is connected with the limit of the resources. In the picture, you see the Earth immersed in a satellite junk. The human's activities has overwhelmed the carrying capacity of the Earth. For this, sustainable design has to be able to manage the disruptive change from the Holocene and supremacy of the man on the nature to the Anthropocene, the cohabitation between man and nature. The sustainable design for the Anthropocene is called to support a new development model for the Earth conservation based, one, on the pressure of human activities reduction, then the best control of the climate, biosphere, and biogeochemistry cycles, two, on a revolution in production based on increase of knowledge intensity to manage the passage from the mechanical to biological cycle. The synthesis of this complex process is a man incorporating a machine and nature. Today, man is a complex artifact, the result of the symbiosis between its original natural dimension and its variation given by technological design to increase its capacity. This happens in a variety of ways. The automa man, the 3D printed man, the robotic man, the drone man, the bio man, the man appears like a publicinat. The second tail, design and man with augmented capacity. The Vitruvius man, thanks to mother computer, get rid of the architect demiurgical presence. This thought, the anarchist architect Negroponte, Alexander Mitchell, and initially Giancarlo De Carlo. Their motto was, we are all architects, thanks to the computer as architect machine. The computer generates a new alphabet based on the deconstruction of the architectural language and on new machine operative rule. The modern software today in use for design geographic mapping is born. In the innovation process started in 1969 with ARPANET, in 1990 with the web, and today with the cloud. The computer constantly changes nature. From a machine supporting project production, it became a machine to manage socially the design, and today a machine to manage design in a collaborative way. This step needs a structural transformation of knowledge processes, from passive teaching to collaborative learning to personalized lifelong learning. In synthesis, the computer revolution generates three social disruptions: the explosion of human capabilities, of human connectivity, of human and infrastructure urban connection. Thanks to the computer, the fourth industrial revolution starts. Today, the computer and the net, thanks to the connectivity between objects and people, produced by cloud and the Internet of Things, generates a new model of city, the smart city. Smart City One, led by high-tech companies aiming to control territory and citizens, the might of fear and security. Smart City Two, led by municipality to improve services to citizens. Smart City Three, led by co-creation with the citizen. The question is, smart city is an Orwellian instrument, or it's producing no new form of proactive democracy? These processes are producing two apocalypses, as write the paper Times. Apocalypse one, new acentric morphologies. In the physical and the social design, architectural machine introduced the concept of acentric technology, with the effect of overcoming, one, the historical, geometrical, discrete form, and two, the concept of proximity, based on historical relationship, space-time. It's the end of the border concept on which the history of the city is founded. Apocalypse 2, body chips, the machine inside the human body. The history of the architectural machine may be a case of disruptive evolution. The chips, the computer technological components, at first are elements incorporated in the machine with the aim to develop a process of democratic choice, and after, to increase human capabilities, connecting people, developing sociality, and connecting things. Which today technology, the chip can be injected directly into human body, so few large companies can dominate the humanity. So, the computer from anarchic instrument producing democratic choice is becoming instrument for platform capitalism of big companies to dominate the men. The third tale concern working inside nature and man. How many British encyclopedias are in one only hair? With this question, in 1958, Richard Feynman reverses the idea of scarcity by introducing the concept of infinite resources working within the materia. Nanotech and biotech are born. It's the end of the third industrial revolution at the beginning of the first one. Feynman asked, what would happen if you could arrange the atoms one by one the way we want them? His answer was, we could build a car running inside the human body. In fact, after half a century, in 1916, the engine running inside the human body was realized by the Nobel Prizes Sauvage, Fraser, Stoddard, and Feringa. Today, the spread of nanotechnologies and biotechnology is exponential. The development model is generative. The raw material becomes biodiversity, and the human body a machine whose capacity can be increased. The construction sector, historically high labor intensive and low productivity, becomes an advanced sector. Its task is transformed from to extract and work matter to work with the genome of the elements with the aim to cultivating houses. Construction becomes part of the biological sector. Urban design process becomes genomic, starts exploring urban forest and classifying the barcode of the elements, goes on activating processes of biological growth of building and part of the town, and ends exploring urban waste mine to reuse material. The inverse process is design passes from nature subtraction to nature addition. The last topic, biogovernance for an anthropogenetic design. Today, sustainable urban design has three dimensions. One, physical, the historical city. Two, neuronal, connection city, and three, genomic, biological city. The city management, so, depends on the synergy of three alphabet: physical, measured in a square meter, communicative, measured in bits, biological, measured in gram of DNA, where 1 gram of DNA is able to store 155 trillions of CD. The sustainable city of the future is consequently the result of the ability of its management to create synergies between these very, very different alphabets. Today, town and its building are the expression of three alphabet: rational, cognitive, biological, three realities that must evolve according to the convention of the environment toward the biological cognitive unity. This evolution requires increasing investment for the sustainable renewal of urban infrastructure and for higher levels of knowledge. The asymmetric city. The big problem is the overlapping of the historical discrete governance model with a new eccentric model imposed by cognitive technology. They require innovative governance, open and agile, but the two worlds are far away because of asymmetries, informational and cognitive asymmetries. The new reality needs a new design approach, metabolic, to increase natural resources, decoupling to increase the resource to face the technological revolution, sustainable to increase the cohesion according to United Nations Urban Agenda 2030. The change in design system thinking is epochal. The public administration is asked to move from a culture of control to a proactive and creative culture, creating a civic impact that needs a new alliance with citizens becoming active subject of the change. The sustainability disruption concept are tested in the design competition New Delhi Horizontal Farm. The design proposes a new settlement for 150,000 inhabitants in a New Delhi area of 30 hectares. The people is a low income, and the design proposes a self-sufficient settlement based on the industrial treatment of waste and intensive use of land for self-food production. The design paradigm proposes an anthropogenic vision based on rehabilitation of natural resources, then a metabolic and resilient approach, and the use of low-cost generative nanomachine like Arduino, 3D printing, Wikihouse to produce artifact. The project is developed in three layers. The three layers are creative use of natural resources, sun, air, water, land, to decrease area footprint and grant food production for the people, self-construction machine to realize physical resources as home, generative fabrication, fab lab, industrial reuse of waste. Central role of knowledge infrastructure, increasing the human capabilities to promote a spatial distribution of function meshed between residence, workspace, and agricultural land. The project idea passes from to-produce tools to generate holistic processes of services and tools, then collaborative action, promoted to increase the well-being of people and the nature. The wealth of the people is granted by two economic cycles, agricultural and waste treatment. Because the settlement realization must occupy a great quantity of people, the design process is imagined like a collaborative effort to develop opportunities and capabilities, then a toolkit system. The collaborative effort to realize the project is based on a playbook with a toolkit system articulated on what function has to develop, whom, for which people, where, in which location, when, in how many time. The toolkit are toolkit for self-production of energy, toolkit for personal microfarm, each home is a farm, toolkit for building auto-construction, toolkit for social space auto-construction, toolkit for waste recycle and biogas production. The final design image, the new settlement like a biological carpet produced by the texture of immaterial fluxes and natural resources. And an equitable physical space in harmony between man and nature. Thank you very much.